to hear the word of God. Do not harden your heart. Rather repent from your sin. As you hear the good news, do not harden your heart. Jesus Christ shed his blood on the cross at the Calvary for the remission of the sin of mankind. The Bible says our sin has separated all of us from God. It is our sin that has separated us from God. But Jesus Christ is not far away from us. Jesus Christ is not far away from us. He loves us. And Jesus Christ is here. He went on the cross and laid his life down for all of us. This is the love of God. That whilst we are all sinners, Jesus Christ died for us. This is the love of God. For God so loved the world that he gave his beloved son to all of us. It was Jesus Christ that took our punishment upon himself. He took our sin upon himself. It was you and I that made to be killed. But Jesus became guilt for us. He became justice. We became just and he became unjust. The just for the unjust. Jesus became the unjust so we might be just. He took our guilt upon himself. He took our death upon himself. He took our punishment upon himself. We're meant to die. We're meant to die. But Jesus Christ died in our place. We're meant to be crucified. But Jesus Christ was crucified in our place. We're meant to face that death penalty on the cross. But Jesus Christ took that death penalty upon himself on the cross. Because he loved us. Jesus Christ says, I am the only way. In this world, there's no other way. For you to be saved, you need Jesus. In this world, there's no other way for you to be saved. But Jesus Christ says, I am the way. There's no other way. Salvation does not come from anywhere, but except through Jesus Christ. The one who died for all of us on the cross. The one that took our sins upon himself. He took our punishment upon himself. We're meant to be tortured, but Jesus Christ was tortured in our place. And he resurrected on the third day. He resurrected on the third day. And Jesus Christ is alive today. As you hear the word of God, I want you to know how much you are precious for Jesus. You are so precious for Jesus. Jesus loves you. Remember, God created you in his image. The Bible says the devil came to kill. The devil came to kill. Look at this world. This world is full of evil. If you die today, where will you spend eternity? The Bible said the devil came to kill. The devil came to steal and to destroy. But Jesus Christ says, I have come that you may have eternal life. Not just that, but in abundance. Jesus Christ says, I am the way. There is no other way. Your money is not the way. Your job is not the way. Your wife is not the way. Your husband is not the way. Your mansion is not the way, but Jesus Christ is the way. Religion is not the way, but Jesus Christ is the way. Jesus Christ is the only truth. The Bible says, let all men be liars. Let all men be liars, but let God be truth. Jesus Christ is the life. He says, I am the life. And you need this life, the everlasting life. You need this life. Beloved, you need this life. And this life is Jesus. Because if you have Jesus, then you have everything in this life. If you have Jesus Christ in your life as your Lord and Savior, repent from your sins. Repent from your evil ways. Repent from your wicked ways, because the kingdom of God is at hand. Bless you, mommy. The kingdom of God is at hand. Don't die in your sin.
Let me cross now. I will wait.
But rather repent from your sin. Repent from your sin. It is our sin that has separated us from God. But Jesus Christ is not far away from us. I want you to know how much Jesus loves you. And without Jesus, you have no life. But if you have Jesus, you have everything. Don't die without Jesus. People are dying. People are dying every single day. People are dying every single day, beloved. And I want you to know, the Bible says a time to be born and a time to die. If you die today, where will you spend eternity? The question I have for everybody today, it is time for you to swallow your pride. It is time for you to humble yourself. It is time for you to fear God and depart from evil and obey His word. If you have Jesus Christ in your life as your Lord and Savior, you have everything, sister. Amen. Because everything will pass away. Everything will pass away. Whatever you see today, they will all pass away. Everything will pass away. The heaven and the earth will pass away. But the word of God I bring to you will not pass away, because Jesus Christ is the word of God. And in the beginning was nothing but the word. And Jesus Christ is the word. And the word was with God. And the word was God. And the word became flesh. He came in a human form. Jesus Christ came in a human form. He walked like us. He eats like us. He did everything like us. But He lifted up the ethics of mankind to a standard. He lifted up the ethics of mankind to a living standard. And He only lived at that standard. He lifted up the ethics of mankind to a standard. But He lived that standard. Jesus Christ says, unless you are born again, you will not see the kingdom of God. Unless you are born again, you will not see the kingdom of God. Unless you repent from your sins. Unless you repent from your evil ways. Unless you repent from your wicked ways. Repent. Because God is not willing that none of you should perish because of His love for you. The love of Jesus was demonstrated on the cross at the Calvary. Nobody died for you, but Jesus Christ died for you. Nobody died for your sins, but Jesus Christ died for you on the cross. He paid a price on the cross. It was Jesus that said, "It is finished." It was Jesus that said, "Father, forgive them, for they don't know what you're doing." Hear the word of God. Great Britain, hear the word of God. We are living in the last days. We are living in the end time. Look around the world. Everything the Bible speaks about is coming to fulfillment. Everything the Bible spoke about is coming to fulfillment. Look around the world. evil has increased everywhere. And Jesus Christ says, this generation is an evil generation. Jesus Christ says, this generation is an adulterous generation. But Jesus Christ came to give you life. He came to give you life. The Bible says, what is a prophet? What is a prophet for you to gain the whole world but lost your soul? What is a prophet? What is the prophet? You gain the whole world and then you lost your soul. The Bible says, love your Lord your God with all your heart. Love your Lord your God with all your might. Love your Lord your God with all your strength. And love your neighbor as yourself. I am one of your neighbors. But I want to tell you the truth, because the truth is always speaking. And the truth is Jesus. Today, this world is full of broken hearts. And Jesus Christ says, I have come to heal the brokenhearted. I bring you deliverance. I preach to you the word of deliverance. The word of deliverance in Jesus. If you give your heart to a woman, if you give your whole heart to a woman, she will give you a broken heart. And if you give your whole heart to a man, he will give you in return a broken heart. But the Bible says, give your heart to God. Love God with all your heart, with all your soul, and all your might, and all your strength. And love your neighbor as yourself. Don't die in your sin. Don't die in your sin. Our sin has separated us from God, but Jesus Christ is not far away from us. Jesus Christ is not far away from us. Jesus Christ says, behold, I am the way. I am the truth and the life. The Bible says, God is not willing that any of you should perish, because you are all precious for Jesus. You are the image of God. And God loves you. Nobody can love you like Jesus. His love is an agape love. Nobody can love you like Jesus. And Jesus Christ says, I did not come for those that are righteous. I did not come for those that are good. But he says, I came for the sinners. I came for the lost. So if you are a sinner, you are qualified. Like I was qualified before. If you are a sinner, you are qualified. Like I was qualified as well. If you are a sinner, you are qualified. Because Jesus loves you. Come to God through Jesus Christ. Come to God through Jesus Christ. Come to the Father through Jesus Christ. God is not willing that precious people like you will perish. Children are dying every day. The youth are dying every day. The youth in this generation are dying every day. The youth are dying every day. The young people are dying every day. Have you asked yourself a question, why? Have you asked why? People are dying. If you die today, where will you spend eternity? That is my message for you. If you die today, where will you spend eternity? You are having and preparing for life insurance. There is a preparation in our life. Everybody prepares for their life. What do we do? But we don't prepare. We don't prepare. We're preparing. How are we going to have a good barrier? You have prepared insurance so that you can have a good barrier on your death day. You're preparing a good barrier. You're living money, you are saving money. So when you die, you can have a good barrier. For your children. But you don't prepare. For your soul. You don't prepare for your heart. But one day, beloved, the Bible says a time to be born and a time to die. If you die today, where will you spend eternity? The good news I have for you is that there is life after death. It is the good news I have for you that there is life after death. There is life after death, but that life comes through Jesus Christ. The Bible says, if you believe the word of God in your heart, through repentance, if you confess with your mouth that God raised Jesus from the dead, you shall be saved. Because the word of God is true. We are all going to give an account one day of our life. We will all give an account one day for our life. Everybody will give an account. In everything we do in this life, there is always a contract. And there is always a security and a risk. Whatever we do in this life, there is always a contract. But a rich version is always written in the letter of Braille. We will all give an account one day, beloved. The Bible says, whatever you sow, that shall you reap. Whatever you sow, that shall you reap. Because Jesus Christ knows that you and I cannot do it. So he came to do it for us. Jesus Christ knows that you cannot do it, neither myself. So he wants us to depend on him. And today, Jesus Christ is the hope of the world. The Bible says faith comes by hearing the word of God. As you hear the word of God, have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Fear God. And depart from your evil ways. Depart from your wicked ways. For the kingdom of God is at hand. Don't die in your sin. On the cross at the Calvary, Jesus Christ walked miles and miles because of his love for mankind. All the way to the cross. He laid his life down. Jesus Christ was not assassinated on the cross. But he offered his life. He gave his life. He gave his life for us. He shed his blood on the cross for the remission of our sin. Jesus Christ shed his blood on the cross for the remission of our sin. For the Bible says that all have sinned. For all have sinned against God. And all have shut forth of the glory of God. For all have sinned against God. And that is why Jesus Christ died for us. He shed his blood on the cross for the remission of all our sins. For the atonement of our sin. And the Bible says, the wages of sin is death. The wages of sin, it is death. But Jesus Christ died for us. The wages of sin is death. But Jesus Christ took our death upon himself so that we might live. And the gift of God is eternal life. The gift of God is eternal life. I bring you God's most precious gifts, and that gift is Jesus. He said, come to me, all ye that are heavy laden. Come to me, Jesus says, because you cannot do it. You cannot do it. You need somebody that is holy. You need someone that is righteous. And that can only be Jesus Christ. He came and lived a righteous life. He came and lived a holy life without sin. Jesus Christ came and lived a holy life. He came and lived a righteous life and lift up the ethics of men to a standard. And he alone lived that life. How do you feel? The good news. The good news is that Jesus Christ shed his blood on the cross for the remission of our sin. Because for all have sinned against God. We are sinners. We have all sinned against God. We have sinned against God. We have all sinned against God. We are sinners. We have sinned against God. The same word of God I'm bringing to you today is going to be our jet tomorrow. The word of God I bring to you today is going to be our jet tomorrow. The prophecy of the word of God is fulfilling. The word of God I bring to you today, my friend, is going to be our jet tomorrow. Jesus Christ is still saving lives. He can change your mess to a message. He can turn your trials to a testimony.
Amen.
Jesus Christ can turn your failure to become a faithful person. That is the power of God. And it's the power of God that can save your soul. It is the power of God that can save your soul. Many people slept last night. They did not wake up. Many people slept last night. They did not wake up. A lot of people traveled today. They did not come back anymore. People have been stabbed everywhere. People have been shot everywhere. Many slept. They did not wake up. People are dying every day. I came to you. That death is no guarantee. Even tonight, it's no guarantee. This very minute, your life is no guarantee. Your life is only guaranteed in Jesus Christ. Your life is only guaranteed in Jesus Christ. Your life is only guaranteed in Jesus Christ. Dear sister, dear brother, I bring you the good news. Because this world is full of evil. The Bible says, whatsoever a man sows, so shall he reap. Whatsoever you sow, that shall you reap. The Bible says, the unbelievers, the fornicators, the adulterers, the idolaters, the haters, jealousy, liars, whoremongers, homosexuality, lesbianism. The Bible says, all who practice such will never inherit the kingdom of God. All who practice such will not inherit the kingdom of God. Unless you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Unless you repent from your sins. Unless you confess Jesus Christ to forgive you your sins. Unless you ask Jesus to forgive you your sins. Repent from your sins. Ask Jesus Christ to forgive you your sins. Ask Jesus to forgive you your sins. Tell Jesus, I have sinned against you. Tell Jesus, I am a sinner. Confess your sins unto the Lord Jesus Christ. Repent from your sins. Ask Jesus to forgive you your sins. Tell Jesus to wash away your sins. Tell Jesus to come into your life and accept him in your life as your Lord and Savior. Because he is the way. Because he is the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father in heaven but except through our Lord Jesus Christ. Don't wait till you die to know the truth, because it might be too late. And I have to be honest with everybody today. If you die today, you open your eyes in a place you don't want to be. If you die without accepting Jesus Christ in your life as your Lord and Savior, unless you repent sincerely, unless you genuinely repent from your sins and ask Jesus Christ to forgive you your sins and accept Jesus Christ in your life as your Lord and Savior and deny yourself, there's nothing in this world. Everything will pass away. There's nothing in this world. Everything will pass away. Your beauty cannot save you. Your money cannot save you. Your boyfriend cannot save you. Your girlfriend cannot save you. Only Jesus Christ can save your soul. Because it was Jesus Christ that died for our sin. It is only the blood of Jesus Christ that can wash away your sins. The blood of Jesus is the only blood that can wash away your sins. It is the blood of Jesus. The Bible says, at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee will bow. And every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Jesus Christ is calling you today because he loves you. Come to Jesus, all ye that are heavy laden. Jesus Christ says, I will give you rest. In Christ Jesus, you have a rest. It's only in the Lord Jesus Christ you can have a rest. It's only in the Lord Jesus Christ you can have a peace of mind. There is no peace in this world. Jesus Christ says, I am the light of the world. Everybody need lights in the night. You need light in the night. But Jesus Christ is the light of the world. And you need that light. Jesus Christ is the light of the world. But the world loves darkness. The world loves its own. But I stand here to tell you about a true light. And that light is Jesus Christ. You cannot save yourself, my friend. Your pride cannot save you. Your ignorance cannot save you. But Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. Jesus Christ says, I did not come for those that are righteous. I did not come for those that are good. But I came for the sinners. I came for the lost. The Bible says, blessed are the peacemakers, for they are the sons of God. Blessed are those that are tested for righteousness and the kingdom of God, for they shall be filled. Blessed are you that you are tested for righteousness and the kingdom of God, for you shall be filled. The Bible says, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. The Bible says, seek ye the kingdom of God first, and all things shall be added unto you. I stand here to blow the trumpets to your ears. I blow the trumpet to your ears to hear the word of God. And as you hear the word, do not harden in your hearts. I bring you the good news. There's nothing in this world. There's nothing in this world, my friend. Everything will pass away. The Bible says, as it was in the days of Noah, they ignored God's word. In the days of Noah, the people ignored God's word. Even though Noah was warning them. Noah was warning them about the wrath of God. They ignored God's word. They were living a lawless life. They were marrying. Evil was increased on their time. Evil has increased in their time. There was murderous. Evil increased in the days and time of Noah. The people were rebellious. They were disobedient to the word of God. And the Bible says, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall be the coming of our Lord Jesus. Jesus Christ says, behold, I am coming with my reward. Jesus Christ is coming, and he comes with his reward. Are you ready for the coming of Jesus? Are you ready, somebody, for the coming of Jesus? Have you repented from your sins? Have you confessed your sins? Have you asked Jesus Christ to forgive you your sins? Hear me out here. You cannot save yourself. You need a Savior. You need a Savior, my friend. I stand here as nobody. But I want you to know that Jesus Christ is the King of Kings. Jesus Christ is the Lord of Lords. The Bible said, for God so loved the world. How much God loves you. You are so precious for Jesus. God loves you, my friend. But God is a holy God. But God is a righteous God. And nobody can come to Him except through a righteous person. The everlasting God is a righteous God. Jesus Christ is a holy God. He is a righteous God. And it takes only Jesus Christ for you to get to the kingdom of God. It takes Jesus Christ. Come to the Father through Jesus. As you hear the word of God, do not harden your hearts. But rather repent from your sin. Repent from your evil ways. Repent from your wicked ways. For the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent. For God is not willing that beautiful people like you should perish. Jesus Christ loves your soul. He's not willing that none of you should perish, but all of you should come to repentance. Change your mind. You need a Savior, my friend. Salvation does not come from anywhere. Salvation comes through Jesus Christ. Salvation comes through Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ is the way. And Jesus Christ is the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father in heaven but except through Jesus. The kingdom of God is at hand. Jesus Christ says, woe unto you on that day. Woe to you on that day. Woe to you on that day, beloved. Woe to you on that day. Jesus says, I will come like a thief on that day. But woe to you on that day. Woe to you on that day. The kingdom of God is at hand. Woe to you on that day. The kingdom of God is at hand. War unto you. War unto you on that day. The kingdom of God is at hand. Don't die without Jesus. Repent from your sins. Repent from your evil ways. Repent from your wicked ways. For the kingdom of God is at hand. The Bible says, for all have sinned. For all have sinned. All have sinned against God. For all have sinned against God. For all have sinned against God. And the wages of our sin, it is death. By the gift of God. The gift of God. Jesus Christ is eternal life. Religion cannot save you. But Jesus Christ wants to have a relationship with you. Jesus Christ wants to have a relationship with you, my friend. The Bible says, what is a prophet? For you to gain the whole world and then lost your soul. If you die today, where will you spend eternity? Your money cannot save you. Your girlfriend cannot save you. Your boyfriend cannot save you. Seek ye the kingdom of God first and his righteousness, and you shall be filled. Blessed are you that you are tested for righteousness, for you shall be filled. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the sons of God. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God.
You were invited.
The kingdom of God is at hand. But woe to you! Woe to you! Jesus Christ comes. These are the days of Elijah. These are the days of Ezekiel. These are the days of Elijah, the days of Noah, and the days of Ezekiel. Jesus Christ is coming. All mankind, the prophecies of the word of God is fulfilling and wrapping up. The Bible says, in the last days, men will be lovers of themselves. In the last days, women will be lovers of themselves. In the last days, there shall rise false prophets. In the last days, there will be rumors of wars. In the last days, nation will rise against another nation. In the last days, there will be several earthquakes. In the last days, there will be rumors of wars. And we live in that time now. Come to Jesus Christ. He said, come to me, all ye that are heavy laden and burdened, and I will give you rest. Jesus Christ is offering you salvation. Jesus Christ offering you salvation, mommy. Mommy, Jesus loves you. Jesus Christ offering you salvation. He said, come to me, all ye that are heavy laden and burdened, I will give you rest. Jesus Christ wants to give you rest. Because it was Jesus Christ that took the sins of mankind upon himself on the cross at Calvary. It was Jesus Christ that took the iniquities of mankind upon himself on the Calvary. It was Jesus Christ that took the punishment upon mankind upon himself on the cross. He took our punishment upon himself. Because he loves us. Jesus loves you. It was Jesus that says, it is finished. It was Jesus that said, Father, forgive them. But they don't know what they're doing. In him was life. And the life was the light of men. If you have Jesus, you have everything. But no Jesus, no life. If you have Jesus, by repenting from your sins, if you genuinely repent from your sins, today Jesus Christ is calling you. As a prodigal son, as a prodigal daughter, he said, come. He said, come, you that you are thirsty. You that you are thirsty, come to Jesus. You will not be thirsty anymore. Jesus Christ says, I am the bread of life. Jesus says, I am the bread of life. Jesus Christ says, I am the everlasting water. He says, I am the living water.
Amen. Amen, my God.
Jesus Christ says, I am the living water. I am the bread of life. He said, he that tested me will not be tested anymore. Come to Jesus. We don't find anybody. God bless you.